Afternoon, everyone. I am Bhumika from SSIT Tumkur. Today, we are here to present our paper on proxy-based data security for cloud data. So let me just start with a quick introduction. As we all know that cloud application is gaining a huge popularity in today's world. And the challenge here is that we have to give the right accessibility to the user's data. The cloud service provider, for this beneficial, he may outsource the data of the users for some data mining as well as some analysis activities. So transparency in terms of security plays a very important role, and it is very important to keep in note that the transparent data transactions has to be between the user as well as the cloud server. Coming with literature survey, the paper is High Utility K-Anonymization for Social Network Publishing by Y. Wang, L. Z. Beijing and others. The problem, whatever we have identified, is that whatever the data that is sent through the network, the cloud service provider may outsource that data. So there is no transparency here. Next paper is the Survey of Privacy Preserving Data Publishing Using Generalization and Suppression by YZU, Tima and others. The problem identified here is that even though they applied so many anonymity algorithms for achieving the key anonymity, so there is no transparency here also. Coming to the system design, whenever the users wants to send any of the data to the cloud, they can't upload that file to the cloud directly. They have to send a file upload request to the proxy server. This proxy server will in turn verify the login credentials for the authenticated user. Then it also generates the metadata. This metadata contains the information like file name, file size, etc. And this will lead to the file to upload into the cloud. The next thing, whenever the user wants to download the file from the cloud, they has to approach the proxy server by sending a file download request. This proxy server will verify the login credential for the authenticated user so that they can download that file from the cloud easily. Coming to the TSM functions, TSM is a transparency service model. In this model, the cloud service provider will not have any access to the user's data. Coming to the TSM functions, the first one is the user registration. User registration is the first step in which the user has to register with the profile creation as well as the password creation. The next one is user authentication. Here, the user will be authenticated by verifying all the logged well credentials. The next one is data save, which is used to save the data. The next one is the data retrieval. Whatever the data that is stored in the cloud platform can be retrieved using this function. The next one is resource setup. Here, all the resources will be provided to the client side. So whenever the cloud service provider wants any of these resources, they can recover from them. Coming to the functional modules, here we'll be using 5 functional modules. All these 5 modules are helpful in the data security as well as the preserving of data. The first one is proxy server. It acts as a gateway between the user and the service provider. The next one is CSP, that is cloud service provider. They monitor all the user transactions like uploading of file, downloading of file, etc. Next, coming to the user. User, along with the valid login privileges, he will be the one who will be accessing all the data records with authentication. The next one is integrity verify. Here we'll be using SHA-1 algorithm, which verifies the current status of a file. If your file is corrupted, you'll get a message saying your file is corrupted. If it is not, you'll get a message saying your file is safe. Next one is the attacker. In this module, even compromising to the service provider, some by external means, some may corrupt this data by using the file name and the secret key. Coming with the implementation, here we'll be using 2 types of algorithm. The first one is MD5. MD5 is a message digest algorithm, which will be producing the 128-bit hash value. It was basically designed to be as a cryptographic hash function and also be used as a checksum, which will be identifying the any errors, and also it verifies the data integrity, but only against the unintentional corruption. Coming with the steps, the first step is appending of padding bits. Padding has to be done in such a way that the length should be even multiple of 5 and 12 bit. The second step is append length. The length has to be appended in such a way that the total length will be length mod 2 power 64. The step 3 is initializing of MD buffer. Here we'll be defining the buffer of 5 and 12 bit block. The fourth step is process message in word blocks. Here we'll be defining the four chaining variables. Each chaining will be of 32 bits. The step 5 is whatever the processed block will be getting as the 128 bit long hash will be given as output. Next is SHA-1 algorithm, that is the secure hash algorithm 1. It is also a type of cryptographic hash function, which is basically used to represent the each file integrity. Next, coming to the working of SHA-1, the first step is append of padding bits. Padding is done in such a way that once as well as how many zeros you want, you can append so that the total length will be equal to the 5 and 12 bits. The next one is append length. The first original message has to be present, then the padding bits has to be at the last. Then step 3 is preparing of processing functions. Here, as SHA-1 undergoes 80 rounds, it requires 80 processing functions, which will be in binary format. The next step is prepare processing constants. As it requires 80 processing functions, it also wants 80 processing constant words with hexadecimal format. The next step is initializing of buffers. Here we'll be initializing as 5 buffers, that is each buffer will be of 32 bit or the 160 bit as usual. The next step is processing the message in 5 and 12 bit block. Here the step 1 and step 2 will be looped together until it forms a 5 and 12 bit blocks. Coming to the advantages, here there is no need of the user to send any of the valid privileges to the cloud service provider. The cloud service provider will not have this access because he doesn't have any of the valid privileges of the user. So here everything will be taken care by our proxy server. This shows the data records in the cloud server to the users. Coming to the disadvantages, the cloud service provider will not update any of the data status to the users properly. There may be a chance of data loss or corruption sometimes. Here the service provider can't outsource any of the users' data. From this, I would like to conclude saying whatever the system we have proposed, that is the transparency service model, which helps in keeping the transparency in between customer as well as the service provider. These are all the references we have gone through. Thank you.